You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. 2019, January. We have our library director, Paul Engel, here. Hey, Paul, how are you?
Hey, Mark, good. How are you?
Happy New Year.
Happy New
2019.
Year.
New stuff at the libraries. We
yes.
are bringing back some programs that happened in the past at the branches.
That's right.
Let's talk about it.
Well, as you know, last year the mayor, city council supported us expanding our branch hours. With the the trustees were on board as well, and it was a great happening for the library and for the city. And so, and with that, we hired new staff. And one of the staff people we hired, Jessica Files, is coming to us. She's our children's librarian,
mm-hmm.
and she comes from a background of early childhood education.
Mm-hmm.
She's incredible with kids, young kids between the ages of birth and like six. That's her sweet spot.
Mm-hmm.
So Jessica is reigniting our story hours at the branches. We're starting this month, and we're starting with one at each branch, and then we're replicating it downtown as well. So
okay.
Let me see if I can read now.
Get your glasses on.
My glasses on. The Tuesdays at 3:30 p.m. at East Branch, which is 54 Kingman Street, we're going to be doing a preschool plus story time. So the idea there is for children ages three and up to bring a caregiver to do songs and activities, crafts. Maybe get a little messy.
Okay.
But that's always fun. We actually say that right here. Please be aware. Some of our projects includes items that could be messy. But we're hoping to really, bring that to life again. And then we'll do that down at Maine on Thursdays at 3:30 p.m. So that's for the older young kids. And for the younger young kids, we have Wiggle Worms Storytime. And that's for ages three and under plus a caregiver. At Mondays at the West Branch at 10:30 in the morning, which is 540 Forest Avenue, we'll be doing that, and then we'll repeat that on Thursdays at 11:30 at the main library. And that's really to take kids and toddlers, just at that early age, and get them moving and get them, tactile things together,
yeah.
get them socializing with other babies. That's a fun age. I enjoy that age a lot.
And so when people say there aren't free activities going on in Brockton, that's not true.
That's not true.
Because they're right there at Brockton Public Library, dedicated staff, new people,
yep.
enthusiastic, that are going to do it. The East Branch and the Main are easy to remember, Tuesday and Thursday, 3:30.
Yep.
The West Branch in downtown, there's an hour deviation. You have 10:30
right.
for West and 11:30 for Main. It'll work. People
tricky.
Get used to
yep,
it.
Yep.
We're going to put up. We'll get
hey.
The artwork from you. And we'll put them up on our community bulletin board, and this
nice.
Will run.
You.
And you can take this and put it up on Facebook.
Great.
So lots of good free things happening at the library. We have more new staff coming on.
We're
soon.
Pretty much staff. I think
okay.
we're all staffed up. We have another new reference librarian.
Right.
He Thomas Ahern. He started on Monday, I believe.
Right. And he
day.
Came all the way from Louisiana.
Came from New
I
Orleans.
I
want
to go
Louisiana.
To Louisiana to visit. He came to Brockton.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Well,
we're glad to have him.
Definitely
maybe
go to
we'll
New Orleans.
Go on a field trip someday. and now also. We have the fabulous makerspace
that's
at the
right.
library
that's right.
upstairs.
Yeah.
Right where it says the People's University, there's a temporary sign that says makerspace. But we got funding back again from the Mass Service Alliance, grant funding to continue that, correct?
Yeah, the Massachusetts Service Alliance, MSA, gave us another $10,000 grant. This is the second one that we've received in a row to continue our mentor program. So we're able to pay mentors to run. Actually, they're running a program down in the Children's Library, which is also a grant-funded Brockton Kids Can Code program.
Right.
And so we're lucky or we're fortunate enough to have that MSA funding to continue this program. We're actually going to try to codify it a little bit more, get a training manual together so that we can once we're done with the Mass Service Alliance money, we can continue the program. In perpetuity.
Well, mentors do need training.
Yes.
And they may have all sorts of skills they can bring, but this a formula for
right.
doing it successfully in a public space, in a public maker spaces are really, happening places. I
yes.
mean, we have one over at Southeastern
yeah.
Where we built the two tiny houses.
That's right. That's
okay?
right.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I know our superintendent likes to spend some time in the makerspace with the kids, and getting your hands dirty, working with kids. If it's messy, that's great.
That is good.
As long as we can clean it up and it's not, you know, you can do the cosmetics later and worry about that.
Yeah, we had to scrape some paint off the art room floor, our gallery floor, you know.
That's okay.
It comes up.
So the number 508-580-7890 is the main library number. Yeah. I always forget the branches.
I don't know the branches.
Okay, so we'll find them and put them up. I think one is...
we just have the main on here.
Yeah, they're on the city website, and we'll find a way to put them up.
Okay.
East and West Branch hours, we're going to, you know, I used to look at the map and get confused myself back in the day when we had more branches. It was mm-hmm. even more confusing. But we're centralizing it. We're hoping to continue to expand.
Yeah.
We're thankful for the public support from the city councilors and the mayor and the legislative delegation. We hope to continue to grow. We've got enthusiastic staff and mm-hmm. we have enthusiastic community because, after all, it is the People's University.
That
whether
is.
They be little people
right.
or big people or older people or younger people, mm-hmm. whatever. And that's what we always envisioned it to. It's turning into a community center because mm-hmm. a lot of different organizations are using it. They're using our big rooms, our mm-hmm. small meeting rooms, and we're in demand. You know that you're full when the parking lot is expanded across the street.
Yes, yes.
Because the only issue we have sometimes is too many cars.
Too many cars, not enough parking.
I got about 3 minutes left.
Oh, really?
Is there anything
wow.
we want to talk about? I know we're in the process of doing a strategic plan. We have a consultant that's
right.
done that. We had two public sessions. There's more work to be done. Tell us about that, if there's anything to update.
Well, we've been in data collection mode at this point. So mm-hmm. we're collecting data from a survey on the website. We've been collecting, as you said, we had actually three meetings. We had the one in the children's room, too.
That's right.
And we've got some good, we're getting some good metrics together. We're seeing patterns. They're not surprising me too much as far as what people want and what they're using in the library. The one surprise was that overwhelmingly the circulation of materials is probably by maybe twice the margin of the next group, the highest thing that's happening. I was really surprised about that. Because I thought in the trends being away from people,
people going online items, and electronic,
right.
They
still want the books. They still want the DVDs.
Because there's no bookstore in Brockton to get any books.
That's right.
At all.
That's right.
It hasn't been for a while, and unless you're getting used books in our bookstore,
right.
which are very inexpensive,
exactly.
really cheap. So the bookstore has hours. You can get
yep.
books. I can't go into a library without either checking them out or buying them.
Yeah.
Okay. Publications, magazines, periodicals. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of electronics, kids' books.
Yep.
I used to pay lots of fines for my kids because they check out stuff and they'd want to keep them forever.
Yeah.
Okay.
That
and
happens.
I know some of my colleagues on the board do too. So website is brocktonpubliclibrary.org.
Yep.
Okay. So on that, lists all of the stuff we were talking about. It lists
right.
the story times. It lists the events. There's a library newsletter that you mm-hmm. can pick up a physical. It's a one pager, two
yep.
sides.
That's online too.
And we have Event Keeper, which lists all the events.
Right.
And I got to commend the library and the library staff for really increasing the presence on Facebook
yeah.
and letting people know about stuff. I usually click interested. That way, if we're going to cover it, it's in my calendar someplace,
right.
and I won't forget to remember that it's happening. Okay, so we'll bring you back, bring others back,
absolutely.
Talk about any of these things. And I love my library, I always have, since I was old enough to sign my name and get a library
get the library card, that's right.
So, Paul, thank you
thank
for
you, Mark.
Being here and coming on Greater Brockton
yeah.
and all the good things the library does. And, in the cold winter months, nothing
yeah.
better than a visit to the library or checking out some materials and bringing them home.
Yeah, and thank you for covering our events as you always seem to do. You always seem to take time to cover them, so thank you.
It's the only way I can go to them and work at the same time. You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.